Okay. I'm going to let him tinker with that for a minute. Get a little hum there, too.
Yeah.
All right. So, welcome to. So you want to be a voiceover, or so you thought you wanted to be a voiceover? So I'm guessing that everyone in here is interested in voice acting. Is that a fair assessment?
Yeah.
Okay. Has anybody had any training of any sort of acting, whether it be voice or stage or? Film, or you have? What have you done?
I do drama college.
Oh, you do?
Yeah, I study.
Okay, great, great. When we talk about voice acting, of course, we're at an anime convention, so that's the first thing we want to think about is anime. But there's a whole lot more that goes into voice acting than just anime. For instance, Jim Cummings is downstairs. Have you all met Jim Cummings?
Yep.
Voice actor extraordinaire out of L.A., has done gazillions of Disney, Warner Brothers, and things like that, video games, all kinds of stuff. So when you talk about voice acting, the number one thing to remember is there are tons of different types of voice acting to do, okay, or voiceover. So you've got anime, you've got animation, you've got video games, you've got books on audiobooks, you've got e-learning, you've got industrial narration, you've got on-hold messages, you've got commercials, television, radio. I mean, it just is really as much as you can think about it. There are so many different applications for voiceover. But in a nutshell, the key to any good voiceover is this. It has to sound authentic. It has to sound like it is coming from here, not from here. So when we get a script up here, you don't want to just read it. You want to tell it. Does that make sense? You want to perform it. You want to act like... So if I'm doing a voiceover, what is your name?
Donna.
What is it?
Donna.
Donna, okay. If I'm doing a voiceover and I'm reading a script, more than likely you're going to be in a booth by yourself. And let's say I'm reading a script and it's an audition for a serial. And I'm talking to my wife, Donna. And I need to talk to her. So I want to, even though she's not in the booth, I want to, you're filming, I'll try to stay in this area just so you get it. I want to be able to put in my mind that I'm talking to her. So I'm actually talking to somebody. I'm not just reading the words like, hello dear, it's nice to see you again. You know, you don't want it to just be dry like that. So voice acting is that. It is acting. You have to act. Whether you're in front of a camera, you're on a stage, or you're in front of a microphone, it is acting. So just being able to like, well, I can do voices or I can do that, that's not really what it's about. It's about being able to convey your emotions and your emotional levels and states via your voice. So the main thing is, okay, at the count of three, I want everyone to say, good morning, how do you do? Okay, at the same time, ready? One, two, three.
Good morning, how do you do?
Okay, every one of you has a different sounding voice. That is your strength. You have a voice that nobody else in here has. It's your voice, and that's what you sound like, okay? So that's your strength. It doesn't matter if you can go, well, I can sound pretty much like John Swasey, or I can sound pretty much like Eric Stewart. They've already got a John Swasey and an Eric Stewart. You need to be you. So focus on yourself. That's the number one thing you want to do. How are we coming? Okay. We've been plagued with some technical difficulties, so... hold on one second. Hey there, I'm in a panel. Did you want to come down? Okay, I'll call you in a little bit. Okay, where was I? Okay, so you want to use your voice. So being able to say, like, I can do a lot of different voices, that's not really... It does come into play. I don't want to say it doesn't, but the main thing is you want to be able to use your voice. So you also might find that you are more apt and comfortable doing a particular genre, for instance, commercials, over anime. Or you might find that you're actually very good at doing characters in anime, but you really can't do commercials that well. So you might, there's all different types of things. So you'll want to explore that. So the one thing you want to do to get started, if you want to get started in this business, is the first thing I would say is, wherever you are, whatever town you're in, find an acting class. If there's a, if you're in a big town, great. If you're in a small town, fine. But find a little acting class that you can get involved with, okay? Kind of immerse yourself into that world. You'll start to meet people, you'll start to make connections, and that's what this business, just like any other business, is all about. So, you know, worst case scenario, I can always just use my computer, they can just read the script off my computer.
Yeah, I was going to say, if you need to, I can go and get mine and read it off mine, but yeah.
If you could, if you can, that would be best.
I can't plug mine up to this visual system, that's the only problem. So
oh, it doesn't have a thing like that?
No, it doesn't have that type of output on it.
Oh, okay. All right.
Which one does he want to open, by the way?
Well, any of them.
Any of them, yeah.
But
I've got a USB sound card. If you want sound from laptop, I've got that with me.
Well,
it's helpful.
No, it's not that. It's we're just trying to get it to open a script, but it's not wanting to read. You know what? This is, well, it's picking it up, so I don't know why, but this is maybe formatted to a Mac.
Possibly.
So, but I would think the, Can you do me a favor and scroll up a little bit?
Yeah.
Keep going a little bit. Ah, too high. Too high.
Just
that. Right there, perfect. Okay. So, all right. Now, so you want to get yourself into an acting class, okay? And start taking acting classes. When you feel the time is right, I would download, you can find scripts online, download some scripts, and get a microphone. You can get a microphone from a guitar center or an electronic store or something like that. You don't have to spend a lot of money, but get a decent microphone, hook it up to your computer, you can download free software. If that doesn't work, use this. I do auditions on this all the time, and I just hold it like this. But we'll get into mic technique in a minute. But you can do auditions like this. You can read and do voiceovers like this. Just have a script here and read the script. And then you want to let somebody listen to it. Somebody that you trust, okay? Somebody that's going to be brutally honest with you. You must have very thick skin to be in this business. Because you will be told no, 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 yes, no, 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 yes, yes, no, 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 no. All the time. So you just have to know that that's part of the business. But you want to let somebody listen to your voiceover that you've practiced with. Let somebody listen to it that's going to give you honest feedback. And if they say you were terrible, say that's fine. What was terrible about it? Just take it as constructive criticism. Now, if you're going to criticize, don't say, well, you suck. You know, that's not helpful. But if you go, you know, it didn't sound believable to me. Okay, well, what didn't sound believable? Let's work on that. So you just practice, 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 and that's really all it takes. Voiceover is nothing but a skill. It's like learning to be a carpenter, it's like learning to be a doctor. I mean, it's, you know, some people might have a little bit more natural ability, but it's like learning to play the guitar. Does anybody play a musical instrument? Okay, how did you learn to play it? You didn't just go buy it and go, well, this looks like fun.
I did.
Practice, 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 practice. It's excruciating. So I'm teaching somebody how for a play at my kid's school in Texas. I'm teaching them how to play the guitar, okay? And for me, I can do this all day long. But it's taken years of practice, you know? So he's trying to get his muscle memory in place to learn where to put the chords. So I can show him the chords. I can show him where to put his fingers and all that. But he's got to practice it so it becomes second nature. And that's exactly what voiceover is like. You just have to practice, 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 and then you eventually will get better and better and better. It's like if you play golf, and you swing a golf club, and when it goes the right way and it's supposed to, it's effortless, and you don't even feel yourself hitting the ball. That's what a good voiceover is like. You're not working, it's not straining, But again, you have to be very thick-skinned, because you're in a booth, right? You're in the isolation booth, and there's walls around you. Sometimes it's a pretty big booth, sometimes it's not, but you've got maybe a glass window right here, and on the other side of the glass window is the engineer who's doing the recording. You've got the producer, maybe the client, various people. And as actors, we're always very insecure anyway, and we want people to love us. So you'll sit there and you'll do a take and you'll say okay, so is this all of us? And a very strong looking bunch. I guess there is safety in numbers. Let's at least hope so. And you look out, and you want to look out the window for approval, did they like that? And you look out, and they're and you're like, God, they hated me. What do I do? What you don't know is they were actually talking about what they wanted to do for lunch. You want Chinese? No. So you got to be careful not to take things like that personally. But anyway, you want to practice. Then eventually you'll need to get a website, maybe get an agent. Somebody to represent you, but you definitely need a website so you can build a demo. And your demo, I try to play you my demo, but I think it's going to be too complicated. If you go to johnswasey.actor, you can see my website and see the demos and that kind of thing. But a demo is about a 90-second example of what you sound like. So Donna, if you put your demo up on a website, it would be maybe four or five different snippets of commercials or examples of what you sound like. But what you would do is you'd want to put something where this is Donna just being Donna. And this is Donna really excited. And this is Donna a little somber. And this is Donna angry. You see what I'm saying? So it's different things like that. When you make your demo, always, always put your very best bit first. Don't ever think I'm going to wow them at the end. Because more than likely, what you'll do is you'll send out postcards or notifications to advertising agencies, to producers, to directors, to production houses, all these different people. And it's going to say, hi, my name is John Swasey. Please come listen to my website and listen to my demo. Maybe you'll hear something you like. And if they do, they'll click play and they'll listen to the first 10 seconds. And if they don't like it, they just click off your website altogether. So you want to make sure you put your very best stuff up front. Now that doesn't mean, so your trashy stuff put at the end, don't even put that on there. You know what I mean? So so you want to get a website. And then voiceover really becomes nothing but a function of marketing yourself. You are the widget. You are the commodity. You have to let people know that you exist. The chances of you getting hired by a production company to do a job of voicing a character is zero if they don't even know you are around. That's just simple logic, right? So, what I'd like to do is get some folks up here. We're going to do a little reading and just try some stuff. But before we do that, I've kind of given you what voiceover it entails. Oh, one other thing, too. The wonderful thing about voiceover is we've got some young teenagers here. You can start at 15. You can start at, I don't know how old you are, your 20s maybe. So, okay, you can start at 26. You can start at 22.
Oh, thank you.
I can start at 52. You can start. It doesn't matter, okay? Now, what it does matter is I can't play the 15-year-old anymore, okay? You can, but then you can't play the curmudgeon-y old dad like I can. So you're going to find where you fit. And as you go through this, you will find your niche. You'll find where you fit in, If you can stretch yourself, that's great. But a lot of times, for instance, in anime, I play a lot of dads. I don't know why, but I do. And a lot of dastardly dads. They're not even nice dads,
You're very good at it.
but that's okay, I'd rather be cast as the dad than not cast at all, But the cool thing is, Or the bad thing is if I'm trying to get something different, people are like, well, I mean, that was good, John, but I really want you for this role because I've got, you know, Todd Haberkorn to do the young kid. I need you to be the old guy. Okay, that's fine. You know, whatever. But again, that makes you kind of a go-to person. You know, they're going to go, oh, we need an old man to do this role. Let's get John Swasey to do the old man. He's not an old man, but anyway. So before we bring somebody up, does anybody have any questions? If you have any questions at all during this, just feel free to raise your hand at any time. Yes.
When did you start?
When did I start? About 20 minutes ago. What? I'm sorry. Where?
Where? What was the first sort of voice? How did you get into voice acting?
Okay. I wanted to be a big actor, big film actor, and I went off to college and came home back to Houston in 1987 when I graduated, and got a job doing live comedy theater, kind of like The Groundlings or Second City, you know, improvisation, that kind of thing, at a Houston theater. It was a very famous theater in Houston, and started doing that, fell in love with improvisation, started doing a little bit of film work, that kind of thing. And then somebody one day said, you ever do any voiceover? And I was like, no, not really. And he goes, well, can you do a, you know, Bill and Ted's Excellent Adventure? You know that movie, Went Away Again? They go, can you do a Bill and Ted? And I was like, totally, you know, or whatever it was. Yeah. So they're like, that's cool. So I got booked to do a voiceover commercial. And I showed up in shorts and a t-shirt, didn't shave, and I walked in. Spent about 30 minutes in the studio doing this commercial with another actor, having the time of my life, and got paid like $500. I was like, all right, I think I want to do this. This is a good thing. I like doing this. But what I also realized is I wasn't doing it every day. So there's, like I said, no, 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 yes, no, 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 no. That's the reality of it. Somebody once said, you know, because people want to do this, and the ultimate thing they want to know is, can I make money doing this? Like, well, of course you can. Sure you can. Anybody can do this. Like I said, it's a skill. I can take my guitar and go make money today. I don't know if I'll make very much money, but I will make money. And the definition of a professional is simply, you make money doing it. So, when I was in New Orleans on a gig, I went down to Bourbon Street, threw open my guitar case, and started playing guitar, and made $20. So technically, I was a professional musician, you know. But the voice acting, it comes and goes, and we do different types of things. You know, I do commercials, I do anime, I do video games, I do a lot of industrial narrations. I do all kinds of different things to really kind of bring it all together. In addition to that, and I live in Houston, so you asked me when did I start? I started in 87, and I lived in LA for about 3 months, but I moved back, and so I've just been in Houston my whole life. I happened to luck out in about 1996. I was doing a lot of voiceover commercials, doing very, very well, and it was a result of my marketing, sending stuff out to people. I landed a couple of accounts and was making really good money. I mean really good money, like six-figure money. And I'm not trying to brag, I'm just saying I know that was a result of busting my butt to find the job. So that's another thing, remember this always. The work in voiceover is finding the job. The job is the payoff for all the work you did to get there. Does that make sense? Okay. And a friend of mine explained it to me. He goes, you can go get a job and make $500 a week, $1,000 a week, whatever it is. Or you can market yourself every day like a real job and get two voiceovers that week that pay $1,000. So it's the same thing, you know. It just, we don't, you know, a lot of people think, well, I want to do voiceover so I can only work 5 hours a week and then have the rest of my time to myself. And it's just like, it doesn't work that way. When I had that one gig, it was a big box store called Builder's Square, and it's a home, tools and lumber and whatnot. And I was doing TV and radio spots every day, all over the country. I thought, this is great. I have made it. It lasted 2 years. I was so on top of the world. I stopped marketing myself. I was so busy, I didn't have time to market myself. One day, I walked in, and I was like, so I'm supposed to be doing some commercials today. They're like, nope. Store's out of business. They closed. What? Just like that, it was gone. And I hadn't been marketing myself, so I had to start all over, you know. So you want to always kind of keep yourself kind of always marketing, 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 marketing. Do it a little bit every single day to kind of keep yourself moving forward. So that's how I got started. Then one day in 1996, a friend of mine, we were at a show. I had a band. Who was at the movie last night? You saw our little movie? Okay. So you remember the country music? That was my band. It was a band called the PC Cowboys, which stood for Politically Correct Cowboys, which was a silly thing. We were a comedy act. But we wrote these original songs that were really silly. And we were doing a show, and this guy was our opening act, and he said, you do voiceover? And I said, yeah, I sure do. And he goes, yeah, so do I. I said, what do you do? And he goes, I do anime. This is 1996. And I was like, what's anime? He goes, well, it's Japanese animation. And I said, oh, you speak Japanese? He's like, no. I dub it into English. Well, I had no clue what this was. But he got me in, you know, made a phone call. I got an audition, went over there, auditioned. Horrible audition. Left, came back in and said, could I try it one more time? And just started doing all these weird voices and everything and going crazy. They're like, oh, that's really good. So ended up getting work. Well, it was a company called ADV Films, AD Vision. And it just so happened that they started off with one studio, then they had two studios. And before, within like 2 years of working with them, they were up to five studios, working from 9 in the morning till 10 o'clock at night, just like a factory. And it just happened to become the number one producer of anime in North America, in our little old town of Houston, Texas, providing voice work for tons of actors. Greg and Chris Ayers, Chris Patton, Vic Mignogna, myself, Jason Douglas, I mean just a ton of people, Tiffany Grant, Lucy Christian, Monica Rial, all these people came out of Houston. And then Funimation started up in Dallas, and so some of the Houston actors started going up there. And then we go back and forth, you know, and then some actors moved up there and then they come down. So now Texas is actually one of the meccas for anime. And it worked out beautifully. And then some people go out to LA and that kind of stuff. But that's so, to that point though, if you're interested in doing anime, no offense to this lovely town, but you probably will not succeed if you want to stay living in Doncaster. It's just because they're not doing it here. You have to move where they're doing it. That would be Los Angeles, New York, maybe Chicago, Houston, Dallas, or Vancouver. Those are probably your six best options for doing this kind of thing. Maybe Florida. But that being said, we also live in the coolest age of media type stuff, because they didn't have it when I was around, but you can create your own stuff and do it from your bedroom, from your closet, and put it on YouTube. Hey guys, come on in. There's a guy downstairs that's sitting with Trina, and I met him, was talking with him. He works on a webcomic based out of Dallas. They've gotten so popular, they started putting their stuff up on YouTube. They're getting like a million hits every time they put something up there. So they're able to monetize this now and turn it into money. I've got a friend named Blake Shepherd, great voice actor, musician. He's working on a show right now called Robot Girl. And it's an anime he's creating. And he's an American animator, but he's doing this in the style of Japanese anime. They're going to be 10-minute shorts. We've recorded a bunch of them. He's doing all the work. They're going to be probably launched later on this year. He's got a Patreon page, if you're not familiar with that. You can check him out. But, so he's creating his own stuff. You can do that stuff too, okay? So you don't feel like, well, I'm stuck in York, and that's where I live, and there's no voice work, so I guess I can't do it. If you really want to do it, you will find a way. Okay, Any other questions before we move on? Nope? Okay, great. So, what I need is a volunteer. Who would like to volunteer? All right, come on up, then we'll get to you. So. Okay.
All right. Can you give us a little more volume, please?
Okay. So, we're going to talk a little bit about technique. So, when you walk into a session, and by the way, if you came to a voiceover session dressed like this, I'd go, wow.
I'll stab my mind.
No. So, bear in mind, when you go to a voiceover session, you know, I was joking earlier about I didn't shave, I was in t-shirt and shorts. That's really not true. I just said that for effect to show that you don't have to be all dressed up and look a certain way. But you do certainly want to bathe, look your nice, you know, dress. You don't have to wear a coat and tie, but look nice. If you're prone to wear a lot of jewelry, don't, because jingle jangles will get into the microphone and all that, so don't do that. But look, I mean, if I went to a voiceover session dressed like this, it'd be perfectly fine. That's fine. So, you get to the session, and we go, welcome, and tell me your name again.
Lily.
So, Lily, welcome. We've got this little thing I'd like you to read. This is actually, would be very similar to an audition for an anime, okay? I don't have the character up there, and I'm sorry, and these guys, thank you all for your help, but we'll just probably leave this alone since this is all we can get up. But a lot of times you'll get an audition sheet. It'll have a picture of the character, maybe a small description of the character, that sort of thing, and then different lines. Now, these lines right here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, are not necessarily they're in order, but they're not necessarily all connected, okay? So, I want you to read them as if they're not connected. That means you want to give a nice little pause in between each one. So, I'm going to let you read this in just a second, just to yourself, to get familiar with it. So why don't you turn around and go ahead and just read that to yourself. So you don't want to do a cold reading where you haven't even read anything. You want to read through it, get through it, and understand the context. If you don't have context, which you don't hear, sometimes in this column right here, they'll give you, pinned down under fire. In the hotel room, in the hospital, whatever it could be. But since you don't have it here, you have to create it. So remember, Donna, earlier I was talking about when you're reading a script, you want to be talking to someone. Well, you're talking to somebody here, okay? So you have to visualize what and who you're talking to. Also, as an audition piece, this is, you want to show your range, okay? You want to be able to show your range like this, whatever it is. You don't want everything to be up here, you don't want everything to be down here, or even everything in the middle. You want it to be all over the place. So, has anybody ever heard of the show, My Bride is a Mermaid? Okay. Have you seen it?
Yeah.
Okay. So I play a character named Gosaburo, who's the dad. And unlike, this is the antithesis of what I just told you. Every line of his, he yelled. So it was like, literally like, good morning! Now get out of my house! Nice to see you! It was brutal. So, but we don't want to do that. What we want to do is really give this some context, okay? And it's okay, as the actor, if you give it the wrong context. You're making a choice. You just have to make a choice and commit to it. What I, as the producer or director, want to hear is, what do you sound like? And so I want to hear something that's got maybe some humor. I want to hear something that's got some drama, something that's got intensity, something that's light, you know, just vary it up a little bit. So you walk into the booth. The microphone is here. We don't
do this. Okay, can you see what I'm doing? We don't do this. We're not kissing the microphone. All right?
What you want to do is you'll stand off to the side a bit, and the microphone will get placed.
So let me clarify, or should I sum up our situation? Or should I?
Okay, I can't read that. So anyway, you want to do it kind of at an angle, so your voice pattern goes like this into the thing, as opposed to straight in like that, okay? So, step in there. Now, when you get in front of the microphone, get yourself situated, okay? You're kind of standing like this. Just relax. Stand like you want to stand. It's very important to physicalize, let yourself be physical, okay? You don't want to move this too much, because you can't go like this. Hey, everybody, let's go! You can't do that. But you can move everything down here. So this can all wiggle and jiggle and move and all that kind of stuff. But if you're, for instance, if you're doing a running scene, actors will go like this, come on, let's go, hurry, hurry, you know, as opposed to, come on, let's go, hurry, hurry, you know, just, you want to physicalize it because it's going to make it more real and believable, okay? So, you're in a good spot, okay? Now, if you do physicalize, make sure you don't do, you know, like that. You don't want to hit the microphone. You're beautiful. Okay. Take a little step closer. All right, good. Now, in between each line, give us a pause, okay?
Okay.
All right, go ahead and go for it, Lily.
So, let me clarify, or should I say sum up our situation? In order to make it out of here, we either kill them or they kill us. Is that a fair assessment? Okay, so this is all of us. Not a very strong looking bunch, but I guess there is safety in numbers. Let's at least hope so. It's simple, really. Survival is like a game, and it's not always the strongest that win. Sometimes all you need is the raw desire to live. Now get in there, oh, and try not to die. Given the current situation, we are not afforded that luxury. Anything that could possibly give away our position is out of the question. I think I speak for the entire group when I say unapologetically, undeniably, and without any shred of a doubt whatsoever, will you shut up for one bloody minute? No. It's not right. This is too clean. Too easy. We're being played. He's lying. Don't look at me like that. I have a good feeling about this and about him, and I'm telling you, he is lying. You know what? I'm gonna say it. I told you so. I know it might not seem like much coming from me, but you have nothing to be ashamed of. Do you hear me? You did the best you could. We all did, but in the end, nothing was gonna save him. He knew that. Let him go.
All right, good job, nice job. Thank you, good job. All right, very nice. Thank you for being our first contestant on The Price is Right. Couple of things. One, and I didn't tell you this, so you would know this. When you see punctuation, like in ellipses, that usually means there's a slight pause. So in an anime script, what we're doing is called ADR, audio dialogue replacement. ADR means we're taking the existing audio track out and we're replacing it with a brand new audio track, more than likely in a different language, okay? That means, though, that it's already been animated. So in American animation, they get the actors around and they do their lines and they perform and everything and they get the audio track and then they animate around that. As opposed to in anime, which is ADR, it's already been done, so we're having to fit the lip flaps. So in, obviously we're not messing with that today and you would not have known that. But, so that's why they have an ellipsis. So when you do anime, we get a translation from the Japanese, then a script writer takes the translation and writes it into, hopefully, a readable, actable script that makes sense. Now, this is good. Count this. It's simple, really. That's five. Now, get in there O, and try not to die. So 10 lip flaps. But in this case, now get in there. After the fourth flap, there's a slight pause. So it's, now get in there. Oh, and try not to die. Sometimes the flaps are really tight. Sometimes, you know, sometimes the writers make mistakes. It could be, now get in there and oh, try not to die. Or it could be, now get in there. Oh, and try not to die. You know, it just depends on what and how it plays out. Okay, now, that being said, also, one of the things that you did wrong, pick on you, but it was... Well, shoot, I don't know where it was, but you completely left out a word. This one? Okay, yeah, you left out, you just jumped over the word. And that's okay, it happens, it's not that big a deal. I mean, again, thank you for stepping up there. So, but the other thing too, Lily, is, again, we're thick-skinned, so this is not a personal attack, you cannot take any of this personally. The only way you're gonna get better is being told you didn't do it right, okay? She was kind of in this zone the whole way. Kind of felt that, there was nothing way up here, nothing down here. You really wanna give it a much broader, so when you're doing
So let me clarify, or should I say sum up our situation? In order to make it out of here, we either kill them or they kill us. Is that a fair assessment? Okay, so this is all of us? Not a very strong-looking bunch, but I guess there is safety in numbers. Let's at least hope so. It's simple, really. Survival is like a game. It's not always the strongest that win. Sometime all you need is the raw desire to live. Now get in there! Oh, and try not to die. Given the current situation, we are not afforded that luxury. Anything that could possibly give away our position is out of the question.
Okay, so, I'm not saying that's the right way to do it or the wrong way or anything like that, but you can see you want to really, really, really commit yourself. Don't be afraid. You saw I was, you know, we're in there, we're over here. Let yourself be physical. Okay, so, anybody else want to give this a try? Okay, well, you had your hand up first, then we'll let you try, okay? Or we'll let you try, then you can try.
Oh, sorry.
That's okay. That doesn't matter. We'll get to it. Okay, take a few minutes. That's always good. Just so you know, if you need time to look over a script, you need time to look over a script. You never, I won't say never, you rarely get the opportunity to have the script ahead of time, no matter what it is. You walk in to do a commercial, they go, here's your copy. The only time you may have seen it prior is if you did the audition and it's the same copy. Yes. No, they'll very much tell you what to do. While you're reading that, I will pull this up and show you. So, I got an audition. Let's see here.
Surely you must get like 5 or 10 minutes in a booth.
Say again?
Surely when you're in a booth and a voice recording, you must get like a few minutes to read the voice.
Well, you can have a few minutes, but it's not always, you know, you can't just sit there and take time, you know, read. I mean, because time is money. Studio's costing 100, 200 pounds an hour to rent, so you don't want to take too much time. Okay, so, this is for a commercial. Specs, AVO, session, $600. Usage, $50,000. Male and female, 25 to 35, looking for both options. We're looking for a conversational voice, friendly, smart, and in the know, tempered with a ting of wit. Nothing too canned or announcer-like. Please submit ethnically diverse voices. DAC is pronounced DAC. Okay. So, they will give you reading. And then the... when I auditioned for Soul Eater, Soul Eater, I was working on a show called One Piece doing Crocodile. And Crocodile, as you know, is, he talks like this, everything, and now listen to me. And again, I get cast as a lot of characters like that. So I didn't know anything about Soul Eater. And I walked into the audition, And Zach Bolton was the director, and I walked in and I go, so here we go, Lord Death, you know, it's like, welcome, I am Lord Death, you know, but it's like, he's like, no, listen to the Japanese actor. So Zach directed me a certain way, he wanted me to be much higher pitched like this. So, yes, you will absolutely get direction. As a matter of fact, in that particular case, I got cast, and even in the recording session, once we started the recording session, about 20, 30 minutes into the session, my voice really hit its stride, and Zach stopped the session. He said, your voice is exactly where I want it to be. Let's start over and redo the first lines, because we were kind of getting into it there. You know what I mean? So, yeah, absolutely, you'll get direction. Okay, what is your name?
Josh.
I have a son named Josh. Not nearly that tall.
Okay, Josh, so.
All right, so step on up. Get a little closer.
Hi.
Good. Now, a lot of times, too, you don't always have to do this, but when you're in a booth, they call it an isolation booth, you'll have on headphones. Obviously, we're not doing headphones today because there's no need. The headphones are really so they can talk to you from outside, so you can hear them. Otherwise, you're like, I can't hear you. But a lot of times, people get in the booth and they put on the headphones, they're like, whoa, I can hear myself. I hear myself breathing. I hear my heartbeat. And then you play, you do a take, and you play it back, and you're like, ouch, I sound like that? So me, personally, I mean, just physiologically speaking, we sound to ourselves a little different than the way other people hear us because our ears are right here, you know? I hate the sound of my voice. I'm like constantly going, why on earth would you cast somebody like that? I'm glad you did, but why? Anyway, okay, Josh, you ready to give it a go?
Yeah.
All right, man, take it away anytime you're ready.
So let me clarify, or should I say something about our situation. In order to make it out of here, we either kill them or they kill us. Is that a fair assessment? Okay, so this is all of us, not a very strong looking bunch, but I guess there is safety in numbers. Let's at least hope so. It's simple, really. Survival is like a game, and it's not always the strongest that win. Sometimes all you need is the raw desire to live. Now get in there. Oh, I'm trying to die. Given the current situation, we are not afforded that luxury. Anything that could possibly give away our position is out of the question. I think I speak for the entire group when I say, unapologetically, undeniably, and without any shred of doubt whatsoever, will you shut up for one bloody minute? No. Something is not right. This is too clean, too easy for me, played. He's lying. Don't look at me like that. I have a gut feeling about this and about him, and I'm telling you, he is lying. You know what? I'm going to say it. I told you so. I know it might not seem like much coming from me, but you have nothing to be ashamed of. Do you hear me? You did the best you could. We all did. But in the end, nothing was going to save him. He knew that. Just let him go.
All right. Great job. Well done. So, Josh, the one thing that I would tell you is, just loosen up. You stood like a soldier the entire time. You never moved from this position. Let yourself go, okay? Get yourself, okay? Oh, this is another thing. It's not that big a deal today. But the microphones, when you go into a studio, probably cost more than your car. Don't ever touch them. Let the engineer touch them. Because if he breaks it, it's okay. If you break it, he's going to break you. You usually get told, please don't touch anything. But that's just sort of etiquette. You don't really ever want to come into a voiceover session and go, hi, I'm John. I've never done this before. Where's the microphone? There's a funny clip on YouTube where the curl is like this. Okay, I'm ready. They're like, we'll get in front of the microphone. Sorry, how's this?
test.
Okay, remember, if we don't speak right into it, you're going to stand right here. We just move you. Stand right like that. There you
go. So you speak at it.
Yeah, you want to, it's here's the microphone. You don't want to do it like this. You want to do it like that. Kind of just. Yeah, he's going to face it. It's okay. Now, most of the time, this is not generally what they do with the scripts. Usually you get a paper script and it sits on a music stand, or they might have a small computer monitor in there and they'll do it that way. But anyway, let's give it a go whenever you're ready.
So, let me clarify our situation. Or should I say, sum it up. In order to make it out of here...
Okay, I'm going to stop you real quick. What did you do wrong?
Accent?
Switch words
nope.
Around.
What?
Switch words around.
You completely rewrote the first line.
Okay.
Writers are very particular about their wording. Okay. Especially in an anime, it's written that way because it hopefully will fit with the flaps. But even in like commercials and stuff like that, don't rewrite this copy. It's written a certain way. In commercials especially, there's a time limit. You know, you've only got 30 seconds, 15 seconds. It's got to fit into a 20 seconds window, something like that. So just make sure you read what is there, okay? Second thing, if you're like this, just let yourself go. Let it out behind you, just let yourself be loose. There you go. That's okay. There's no being nervous is okay, all right? Just take a deep breath. Just relax. The thing you, let me tell you, I was very nervous the very first time I got, not my first job, but when I started marketing myself in earnest, I sent out, we have a sandwich shop in Texas called Antone's, and they're what's called a po' boy. So like a, you know, salami, ham, cheese, and a long bread. And they're very popular. I took my demo tape, back then there were cassette tapes. Some of you may not even know what a cassette tape is. I took my cassette tape in a brown paper bag with an Antone sandwich, a bag of potato chips and an apple, and a little card that read, "How you doing?" Oh, and I had on the cassette case, I was in a cowboy hat and a poncho doing a stupid face like, and it said, "He's good, he's bad, and he's ugly. So he's perfect for your voiceover." And I took that and I had a little card and it read, "My name is John Swasey. I'm a voice actor here in Houston, Texas. Today your lunch is on me." And I hand delivered these lunches to about 300 different offices and producers around the city. It took a month. I got two responses. Two. One was, "Hey, this was really cool. Nice job. We don't really have anything, but we're going to keep you on file." All right, that was a nice attaboy, pat on the back. Second phone call. "That was really cool. We love Antone sandwiches, and we do have some work for you. We've got 9 television commercials and 9 radio commercials to do. Would you be interested?" "Yes." So this was way back when I was in my late 20s. I was waiting tables at the time. Now in America, we do, the waiters make tips. That's how they make their money. So you have to really bust your butt. And I did this in 1 month. I went in and made about $4,000 in about an hour and a half doing these commercials. And I went, "Wait a minute." I worked for about 2 hours a day working to get the job. I got the job, made $4,000 in a month. See you later, restaurant. I'm doing this. And I never stopped, and it just kept growing. So, but when I walked into that session, I was so nervous. Because you do a take, and they go, "Okay, that was fine. Let's do it again."
What was wrong with the first one?
"Well, it wasn't very good."
"What do you mean it wasn't very good?"
"Well, just do it again. Just loosen up. Have more fun with it. Put a smile on it."
"It's kind of like..."
"Okay, smile, sure." When they say smile, and they will always say smile when you do the commercial, physically smile.
"Is it true
smile.
That you can do hand gestures and stuff in the book as well?"
"You can do, yeah, that's what I'm saying. Be physical, but smile. Don't go, all right, I'm smiling in my mind." Smile. It just sounds better. It sounds happier. It's got more energy. You can have more fun with it. Smile. So I'm doing these commercials. I'm like, on take 9. I'm like, "What is wrong with me?" And finally, we took a little break, and the producer goes, he was my age, he's a friend of mine. He's like, "John, what's the problem, man?" "I feel like you're setting, you don't want me to fail. He's like, what are you talking about? It was my own insecurities that were bringing me down. He goes, John, we're paying you a boatload of money. We want you to do good. Do good. We know you can do it. We can't do it. That's why we brought you in. So you don't want to be cocky about it, but know that you're in this booth right here because they can't do what you can do. All right? They don't sound like you can sound. Only you can sound that way. Again, it's not about being cocky. It's about being confident. Okay? So it's okay to be nervous, but just relax. Okay? We're all here to judge you. I mean, we're not here to judge you. Okay, give it a go. Give it a go.
So here?
That's good.
Here.
That's fine.
Okay. So let me clarify, or should I say, sum up our situation. In order to make it out of here, we either kill them or they kill us. Is that the...
Okay,
the problem
good.
For me is it's a bit too back.
It's too what?
It's too... It's tilted. See what I mean? Like the text is kind of tilted a little bit.
Now, I'm sorry, but I don't know how we can do that. Well, you've got hair in your eyes, for one thing.
No, I can't see from here.
Okay.
Don't worry about that. That's like a post-it checklist.
Real quick, though, when you make a mistake, you go like this. So let me clarify, or should I say sum up our situation okay, that's no good. There's no way an editor's going to be able to edit that. So if you make a mistake, which we all do, we misread words and all that, it's fine. So let me clarify, or should I say sum up our situation. So you see what I did? I messed up, you pause, do it again, just start that sentence over. If you mess up down here, there's no need to go back to the top.
Yeah.
But start at the beginning of the sentence that you messed up. Then give it a nice little pause so the editor has room to chop it, get it out of there, and marry it together.
I love the mistakes
for
just making this final
thing. Okay, here we go. Relax, arms to your side. Good.
So let me clarify, or should I say, sum up our situation. In order to make it out of here, we either kill them or they kill us. So let me clarify. I'm done. I've run out of patience.
Okay. All right. Come on.
No,
get through the first one.
I can't even get through.
Yes, you can. Yes, you can.
I keep forgetting the words in front of me.
Well, then just send, end it and kill us.
It kill us.
No. Just don't say, is that a fair assessment? Just stop at the word kill
us. Okay. So let me clarify, or should I say, sum our situation up. In order to make it out of here, we either kill them or they kill us. Is that a fair assessment?
Good, all right. Okay, we are just about out of time. I maybe got time for one more. Who's next in here? What's the panel? Okay, good. I don't want to go over my time and go into their time. So we'll be. I've got about 2 minutes. Is that okay? All right. We have one more. Does somebody want to try? Okay, come on up. Also, remember, find an acting class. That's the first thing, the most important thing. If you haven't already, friend me on Facebook. And if you ever have questions, feel free to message me, and I'll help you out as best I can. Now, you can also maybe look up, depending, I don't know if they'd have it necessarily in Doncaster. They might. But you might look up voice acting training. They might have somebody here that does that kind of thing, okay? So we do that in Houston. Like what we're doing now with you, we bring you into the studio, we do private lessons. They can get pricey. We charge about $150 for an hour and a half or $200 for 2 hours. So, but it's very intensive, one-on-one working. So you're going through a bunch of stuff, okay? But you might try to find somebody like that. I'm sure there's somebody like that in London. But you might try, I don't know, how big is Doncaster? People. How many? Okay. Well, anyway, just look around, but acting class for sure. Okay, so do you think you've got it? You need to read through it, or do you want to give it a go?
I'll give it a try.
Give it a try. What is your name?
Stephen,
all right, Stephen.
So let me clarify, or should I say, some of our situation. In order to make it out of here, we either kill them or they kill us. Is that a fair assessment? Okay, so this is all of us? Not a very strong-looking bunch, but I guess there is safety in numbers. Let's at least hope so. It's simple, really. Survival is like a game, and it's not always the strongest that win. Sometimes all you need is the raw desire.
Start that sentence again.
Sometimes all you need is the raw desire to live. Now get in there. Oh, and try not to die.
Good job. Oh, good, good. Well, you have a lovely voice. Thank you very much. Anybody have any questions? Yeah, there we go. Anybody have any quick questions? Yes.
On my phone, I
want
to record myself reading a scary story. Why don't you know what
to say? Yes, it is. Absolutely. When you're acting, when you're doing a commercial, whether you're doing this, you're doing something about Coca-Cola on sale, you're telling a story. So it is a story. So yes, absolutely, that's voice acting. You bet. You bet. Okay, guys, thank you all so much. You've been fantastic. Enjoy the rest of the evening. I'll be outside
and have fun.
And if you have any questions, don't hesitate to ask me, okay? Thank you.
This is Shinigami, Lord Death, reminding you to be at Sunnycon Anime Expo this June. Be there or I'll come give you a rip-a-chop.